Welcome to the W3Schools CSS Lists tutorial. The CSS List properties allow you to set different list item markers for lists or set an image as the list item marker. In HTML, there are two types of lists. Unordered lists, where list items are marked with bullets, and ordered lists, where list items are marked with numbers or letters. With CSS, lists can be styled further, and images can be used as the list item marker. Let's take a look at some of the different list item markers. Here, there are four different lists. These two are unordered lists, and these two are ordered lists. The markers for unordered lists can be a circle, a square, or the default value, which is a filled circle. The markers for ordered lists are all some kind of number or letter. The default is numeric, like this 1, 2, 3. But it supports many different kinds of numbers or letters from different languages and cultures, like Georgian. And many others. To specify an image as the list item marker, you can use the list style image property. Here we have a purple square as the list item marker. It's set using the list style image property and the URL for the image you want to use. Let's try and change it. The problem with using the list style image property is that it will not display the same in all browsers. Internet Explorer and Opera will display the image marker a little bit higher than Firefox, Chrome, and Safari. If you want the image marker to be placed equally in all browsers, we can use a cross-browser solution where we set the list style type to none and we set the padding to 0 and margin 0. Now we want to set a background image for each list item. Let's see. We want this image to be shown only once, so we set the background repeat property to no repeat. And we don't want the text and image to overlap, so we set the padding left so we can move the text a little bit. And I feel like the images should be a little bit more centered. I want to move it a few pixels down so I can use the background position property. And move it 2 pixels down. And the list items are a bit cramped, so let's give it some margin. Now we have a list with image markers that will be shown the same way in all browsers. It's also possible to specify all the list properties in one single property. This is called a shorthand property. The shorthand property used for lists is the list style property. Here we use the list style property to set the list style type and list style image. The reason we have set both these properties is that if the image is unable to load, we use the backup list style type. The order of the values for the shorthand property is list style type and list style position, which can be set to inside or outside, and the list style image. Doesn't matter if one of these values are missing, as long as the rest are in the specified order. Let's take a closer look at the list style position. The list style position specifies if the list item markers should appear inside or outside of the content flow. Let's add the border to our list items to demonstrate this. Now, the list style position is set to inside, and the marker appears inside of the border or inside of the content of the list item. If we change the position to outside, it will appear outside of the content of the list item element. On the W3Schools tutorial page, there are more examples and we list all the CSS list properties. And there's a link for each property that goes to our CSS reference, where you can find more information for any CSS property. And this concludes our tutorial for CSS lists. Thank you for watching.